How would he be received here in the Burnhams, now that he was a post-captain? Even unemployed and far from complete health, that made him somebody. Perhaps enough of a person in the county not to fear too much from his present situation. Against that, his elder brother Morris, now toiling in the same navy office his uncle Suckling had run, warned him of the poor prospects facing idle captains forced to exist on half pay. Rattling along past sights so familiar they tugged at his emotions, it was easy to conjure up the image of a rural idyll, a place of content, where the well-respected Captain Horatio Nelson would be of some standing in the community, a man to elicit a raised hat from the gentry and a doffed cap from labourers and tenant farmers. Yet it was foolish to compare his standing here with the respect he was shown aboard ship. What could he hope for here except obscurity? The notion of being indistinguishable from the herd had never appealed to Nelson. Though he knew that his desire for recognition carried within it the sin of vanity, he could not help but crave it. It had been with him all his life. Even as a child he had sought to outdo his siblings. His father would be there to greet him, the same man who had looked after him so assiduously in Bath. Illness had not spared the rector's son oft-repeated homilies regarding his manners, the forthrightness of his opinions, or how those impacted on his prospects for advancement. That his father insisted he recuperate in Bath had made sense, but the fact that he actually liked the place amazed Horatio Nelson. Why leave his parishes in Norfolk, where he was a highly regarded individual, to travel to a West Country town where he melded seamlessly into a flock of non-entities taking the waters, bowing and scraping to those they considered their social superiors?